What's up, everybody? Jacob, JK Productions. I've never done something like this before, but it is kind of a big deal for me today. This is going to be my last ever football game commentating for FAU. I've had a really great time doing so. I've met some great people, had some great opportunities that hopefully can spring me forward, as I really love to do this for a career. But yeah, this is my game day vlog of really everything that goes into me commentating a game for FAU. Never done anything like this before, so bear with me, as it's my first time ever doing any sort of vlog content. But yeah, very big for me. I've had a great time doing this, and I've been really thankful for all people following me throughout the years. A couple police there, hopefully they don't mind me recording. But yeah, I'm really excited for today, play University of Alabama Birmingham, so let's get this going. Just picked up some Starbucks. Shout out to Haley. I get the iced chai tea. Coffee is gross. Please let me know in the comments that you agree. Coffee is gross. Tea all the way. Okay, so this is the last part of the not exciting stuff before we actually get to the stadium. To do our games, it's literally just Discord. Like, we don't get any fancy technology or nothing. I say that like I'm 80 years old. But yeah, just come in here, put this on Discord, the tablets I have in my car. And that's really it. Like, there doesn't go a lot into doing the game day stuff here. Wish we had more stuff, but that's what we got. So this is, I just have to come here always before the games start, make sure everything's right, and then now we go over to the stadium. So we made it to the top of the stadium up here, the sixth floor FAU football stadium. We got the two teams practicing right now. It's looking very light outside, so I'm not really expecting a big crowd today. FAU, UAB. Shout out to Hoover. This is Mississippi Sweets Barbecue Company. They cater this, free food and stuff. This is my little office. Been up here last year and a half, and like you guys already know, it's gonna be my last game. It's very bittersweet. Like, I've had such a good time doing these games, and it's provided me such good opportunities. And I'm gonna have fun time tonight, but I'd be lying if I said I wasn't a little upset. But I'm excited. Game is gonna be starting in 55 minutes, so I'm gonna eat my food, do the rest of my preparation, getting ready for the game. So we are 23 and a half minutes from game time. I got about all my setup here. FAU does a great job of providing these notes for everybody, so it really makes my life a lot easier. They give like really thick packets of information for both teams. Got all the teams' players right here. And then right before game time, what I usually do is I'll write a little script to do an intro with. Here we have, of course, the Gators losing to Georgia. Shocker. But yeah, this is probably the last thing you'll see before either the start of the game or the intros. As I'm just finishing up my prep here, that's the tablet I use to do everything. So got everything set up a little ahead of time, a little ahead of schedule. I'm here by myself today, so a little easier to get everything set up. So we got my live stream right here. Everybody on the live stream, say hi. We got the game just started. 8 minutes, 9 seconds coming, or 8 minutes, 9 seconds still on the clock. I guess can't see that. There you go. 8 minutes, 9 seconds left to go. Each team's possessed the ball so far. Being in the booth here by myself is definitely a different experience. Not used to this. We are back here. 3 minutes, 30 seconds, 7 seconds left to go here in the first quarter. FAU takes the lead with a Morgan Suarez kick. This kick is very poorly done, as the return man for UAB tries to catch the ball, bounces out of bounds. However, there is a flag marker on the play, so it may be a kick out of bounds. There is no penalty flag on the play, so that means the UAB Blazers will be taken over on their own 4-yard line. A mental lapse there
by the return man. As he tries to field the ball on the sideline, it hits him and bounces out of bounds. So the Blazers will be setting up shop deep within their own territory here on their third drive of the game. We are back here. Thank you for tuning in to FAU OWL Radio. Nicozy Perry, shotgun formation. Johnny Ford in the ball game alongside him. Nicozy takes the snap, passes the out to his left. Johnny Ford able to get to the outside and is shoved out of bounds at the 40-yard line. Now, a defensive lapse leads to a Johnny Ford touchdown. The FAU Owls take a 9-7 lead as Borges Suarez now comes out for the kick.
So through the first quarter, FAU has a 10-0 lead and have been killing it. UAB is without their starting quarterback, which sucks for them, but I don't want to hear it. Everyone's got people beat up, and the Dolphins can do it. Well, actually, they didn't do it. James Eno, their backup quarterback, has not looked great so far, and the Owls put together two pretty good possessions here with a 10-0 lead through the first quarter.
So 8:08 left here in the second quarter. Blazers look very good in the last two possessions, taking a 4-point lead now over the Owls here, as there's only 8:08 left to go here in the second quarter. This has been a roller coaster of a game, as I look to turn that around. FAU looked great on their first couple possessions, and quite the contrary for UAB. In their first three drives, there was just nothing going for them. 37 yards total, and things have completely turned around here in the second quarter for UAB. So it is halftime now. UAB up 14-10 with a missed field goal there at the end of the half. FAU gained the ball back at the start of the second half. UAB's offense really turned things around there in the second quarter. FAU looks kind of dead with three and outs in the third quarter. Hopefully it looks a lot better in the second half. Trying to turn things around here.
Shout out to the Bun Cakes. Nothing Bun Cakes? Love it.
Owl, Nicozy Perry, shotgun formation now. Two receivers to his right, one to his left. Takes the snap, looks to his left, looks, and hits his man, Jamal Edgerton. However, the ball falling incomplete. Jamal had his hands on the ball, is angry with himself, as now brings up a 3rd and 13 here on FAU's first possession of the second half.
And we are back here at FAU Football Stadium. FAU takes the lead with a long touchdown pass. Nicozy Perry connecting deep down the field to Jaquan Burton to take a 17-14 lead.
And we return here, 10 minutes, 14 seconds left to go here in the third quarter. FAU Owls with their second possession of the half as Nicozy takes a snap, hand the ball up the middle to Zabiri Mobley. Breaks one tackle and is eventually tackled after a 2-yard gain on the play.
Shout out to Donovan. All these comments. Donovan, you're a real one. Hanging out with me here tonight. All these comments, bro. Appreciate you, sir.
Let's go here in the game. UAB with their first possession of the fourth quarter. Jacob with the play action, look deep down the middle field, able to hit his man at the 30-yard line. Third reception of the game there. Dexter Boykin able to pick up the first down there. Let's move UAB further away from their own goal line. We are back here with only 5 minutes, 5 seconds left to go in this ball game. Nicozy Perry and company coming back after a huge defensive stop on fourth down. Coming up with the play for FAU was number 22, Jaden Williams, flicking the pass, leading to the fourth down stop. Now with 5 minutes left to go, and FAU maintaining a 7-point lead, hoping to control the ball, take some time off this clock, and win this ball game. Now back from a FAU timeout, 2nd and 10. Jacob Zeno, Dwayne McBride, taking this ball down into FAU territory on the 23, 2nd and 10. Jacob Zeno drops back, has all the time, rolling out to his right and chucking it downfield. And is it completion? No good. Out of bounds calls the side referee. The side judge, Jermaine Livingston, calling out of bounds there on the play. Unable to get the toe tap there was the UAB wide receiver. Third and 10, 14 seconds left to go. If you're not excited, I don't know what's wrong with you. If you can't feel your heartbeat, or what did Mike McDaniel say? This is what we live for here. 14 seconds left to go. Third and 10. Jacob drops back, looks left. Targets the end zone, has a man 1-on-1, and the ball sails out of bounds. Some pushing and shoving there by the wide receiver and the defensive back there for FAU on the play there. Number 22, Jaden Williams. 8 seconds remaining. FAU 24, UAB 17, 4th and 10. UAB is putting themselves together a very serious drive here. Try to put points on the board, perhaps force overtime, maybe go for two if they end up getting it. But first, a 4th and 10 from the FAU 23. Two receivers either side of Jacob Zeno. Alongside him in the backfield is Brown Jr. Looking to the right, looking into the end zone, has a man. He dropped it! That is the game! FAU will be walking out of here 4-5 due to a great defensive play there to disrupt the pass. Number 24, Michael Antoine Jr. there, deflecting the pass in the back of the end zone. FAU be taking the ball over on downs, and we'll move to 4-5. We'll move to 3-2 in Conference USA.
So that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed this. This is a big game, big day for me. Last time ever getting an opportunity to do this. First time ever uploaded a vlog, so I hope it went well. But I really can't stress it enough. Like, I'm so grateful for this opportunity that I've had over the last year. The opportunities that it's brought me, the people that I've met, the people that I've worked with. It's been amazing. And I'm not done here at FAU. I'm not done working, because I have now the women's basketball team to work with, and I'm so excited to do that. But my time here in the booth here has been amazing. I've had such a fun time doing it. I'd just like to thank so many people for all the help. Jacob Brown, Adiel, all the people I've worked with over the last year or two. It's been super fun. It was a great game. FAU obviously won 24-17. I couldn't have asked for a better game. So I'm so happy that the FAU Owls won. So it's bittersweet coming out of here, my last game ever, thankfully with a win. Thank you all for tuning in to JK Productions. Jacob Kelly signing off, last time here in the booth. I've only gotten a little emotional, a few tears here and there. But thank you everybody who supported me along the way and continue to support me. I can't say enough, so I'm just gonna stop right there. So I hope everybody has a great rest of your day. Thank you all very much for watching. I'll see you next time. One last thing, you gotta leave on a make. Bye.